Over the last few years, we've seen the use of paddle-shifted gearboxes become much more prominent in both professional and semi-professional levels of motorsport. Now, there's a lot of people out there that believe that paddle-shifted gearboxes really take away from the racing experience, reducing the skill level required from the driver. Regardless of this, we can't argue with the fact that paddle-shifted gearboxes improve driver performance, reduce lap times, and are actually also much easier on the gearbox components. In this video, we're going to delve into how a paddle-shifted gearbox works using the Motec M150 GPRP paddle shift control ECU. The advantages of a paddle-shifted gearbox are numerous. First of all, due to the way the paddle-shifted gearbox is operated by the ECU, the driver can perform upshifts without needing to use the clutch or without needing to back off the throttle. This means that the power from the engine is almost uninterrupted, and particularly with a turbocharged engine, this means that the turbos don't fall off boost. So this improves acceleration under wide open throttle as the driver goes through the gears. The other aspect here is that under a downshift, the driver doesn't need to manually blip the throttle to match revs. Instead, this is all done with the drive-by-wire throttle control via the ECU. This allows seamless downshifts, and again, the driver can concentrate on braking, which is normally what they're doing when they're shifting down through the gearbox. Some drivers also will then adapt the technique of left foot braking because the clutch isn't required. Since the driver doesn't need to use the clutch, doesn't need to heel and toe on the downshift to match revs, and can keep both hands on the steering wheel, this all adds up to an improvement in the driver's concentration, allowing the driver to concentrate solely on the task of braking, positioning the car on the racetrack, and cornering correctly. All of this obviously can add up to an improvement in driver confidence and a reduction in those lap times. Delving a little deeper into the braking performance, data's actually shown that even a professional racing driver using a manually shifted sequential gearbox and heel and toe downshifting can't maintain a consistent and maximum braking effort. Every time the heel is used to blip the throttle to match RPM on the downshift, the maximum braking effort is momentarily reduced. So understandably, using a paddle shifted gearbox where the driver can concentrate on maintaining maximum braking effort is going to result in a reduction in braking distance. The heart of the paddle shifted gearbox actually starts with a conventional sequential dog engagement gear set. It's the dog engagement design that allows the paddle shift system to be shifted so quickly and so seamlessly. Each gear inside a dog engagement gearbox has a set of teeth or dogs machined into it. The selector that slides between the adjacent gears also has matching drive dogs. By moving the selector towards one gear, the dogs will engage with the matching dogs or teeth on the gear, and this is how the drive is transferred. There's a back cut on these dogs, and once torque is being transferred or the engine is under power, it's almost impossible to pull the gearbox out of that gear. In order to actuate a shift, the driver will ask for a shift by pulling on the upshift paddle behind the steering wheel. This sends a signal to the ECU, and from here the ECU will reduce the engine torque, which allows those dogs to disengage. There are a number of ways that this torque reduction can be achieved. Typically, an ignition cut or a fuel cut will be used, or sometimes both of these simultaneously. In addition to this, retarding the ignition timing will further reduce the engine torque, and this can be used to smooth the reintroduction of torque when the fuel cut or ignition cut is removed. Once the engine torque is reduced, a pneumatic cylinder is used to move the selector from one gear into the next. This can happen very quickly in a matter of only 30 to 40 milliseconds, so it's much faster than a typical manual shift. Since everything is happening incredibly quickly, it's essential for the ECU to be able to monitor exactly what's happening inside the gearbox at a very high speed. One of the key inputs to the ECU is the gearbox position sensor. This is fitted to the barrel of the gearbox and allows the ECU to see when the next gear is engaged. This is essential to the operation because here the M150 ECU performs what's known as closed loop gear control. What it does is it monitors the gears, and the torque reduction is only reintroduced when the next gear is properly engaged. This is one of the keys to improving the reliability in a dog engagement gearbox. If that torque is reintroduced too early, it's very easy for the dogs to clash together, and this can quickly round the dogs and result in damage to the gearbox, which is very expensive and will require repair work. If we don't correctly match RPM on the downshift, this can easily result in compression locking, which can result in the car becoming unstable or even spinning under braking. The downshift starts with the driver requesting the shift with the downshift paddle. Again, this sends a signal to the ECU. Here, the ECU will reduce the torque loading on the dogs to allow the shift to complete by applying a small amount of throttle. Once the shift is begun, the throttle is then blipped further in order to increase the engine RPM and match the RPM of the next gear. This is all pre-programmed into the ECU because there is a table that defines the gear ratios. This means that the ECU is always able to calculate what the correct engine speed would be for any particular gear. This also allows the ECU to apply an engine RPM limit so that the RPM doesn't exceed the RPM that the next gear will achieve. This ensures very smooth downshifts and makes it very easy to achieve the correct RPM match. Understandably, with this complex paddle shift system, there is a lot of calibration to do in the ECU, and there is a lot to get right. Here, the devil really is in the detail, and as tuners, we're relying heavily on very high-speed data logging to see exactly what's going on with the shift and how our calibration needs to be changed to optimize the shift settings. Well, there's definitely those out there who argue that the paddle shift system takes away from the driver's skill level. There's certainly no argument that a correctly set up paddle shift system will make a car faster, make the driver's job easier, and also make the gearbox components more reliable. If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.